At first glance, sun, moon, stars, rain is just a jumble of unrelated, nonsensical phrases. And I might say as a singer, very difficult to learn. But digging a little deeper, this poem by E.E. Cummings, set to playful and sometimes melancholy music by composer David L. Brunner, begins to grow on you and maybe even make sense. The poem captures the ordinariness of life. A man named Anyone lives in an average town, gets married to no one, and eventually dies. The repetition of the seasons represents the cycle of life and passage of time. Dr. Oliver Turrell, lecturer of English at Loughborough University, summarizes it this way. The poem is a celebration of anonymity, and that it is perfectly possible to live a full and exciting life, to love and be loved without being anybody special. Being anyone is enough. We hope you enjoy this unique and surprising piece sung by anyone's and no one's.
Anyone lives in a pretty hotel with ups so floating many miles down. Spring, summer, autumn, winter, he sang his dint, he danced his dint. Women and men, both little and small, cared for anyone, not at all. They showed their isn't, they reaped their sin.
Measure Me Sky. The lyrics of the song are a poem of the same name written by Lenora Spare. The poem was first published in 1922. Lady Spare was a concert violinist as well as an accomplished poet. She won the Pulitzer Prize for Poetry in 1927 for some of her other works. The text was set to music by Jonathan Reid, a choir teacher and composer, in 2020. The constant motion in the piano accompaniment and the soaring vocal harmonies combined to give the sense of lifting off from the earth and flying, rising above the clouds to a night sky filled with stars. We hope you enjoy Measure Me Sky.
Prophet of pain, in the score of a 1965 musical of the same name and was written by composer Burton Lane and lyricist Alan J. Lerner, both of whom were well known for their work on Broadway. A film version of the musical that was released in 1970 starred Barbara Streisand and featured actors Bob Newhart and Jack Nicholson. Over the years, the song has been covered by numerous artists, including Frank Sinatra, Sammy Davis Jr., Johnny Mathis, and Tony Bennett. A jazz cover by the Peddlers was also incorporated into the soundtrack of an episode of the show Breaking Bad. We are performing an arrangement by prolific American composer and arranger Carl Strommen.
Centered on the moon. This is the perfect time to give you some trivia about the moon that you may not know. Now, obviously, sunlight is warmer than moonlight, but did you know that if you take a digital thermometer and measure the temperature in the moonlight, and then move under a tree and again measure the temperature, this time in the shade, you will find that the moonlight is colder than the shade. In spite of its name, this information has absolutely nothing to do with our next song, Cool Moon.
Cool. medium swing arrangement full of tight harmonies and wondrous dynamics that was composed by Will Hudson and Irving Mills. In the year 1933, this song was first recorded by jazz musician Joe Venti. Shortly after, it was adapted by the Benny Goodman Quartet in 1934 and quickly became a number one hit. It has since been arranged by Darmon Meader of the New York Voices fame. Moonglow has become a jazz standard, performed and recorded numerous times by a wide array of musical talent. We hope you enjoy Moonglow.
From two Shakespearean works, The Merchant of Venice and The Tempest. Now, William Shakespeare did not normally write music. He used music. Shakespeare would insert into his plays contemporary ballads and songs that fit his purposes. And in his day, in Shakespeare's day, music was divided into three great spaces. The idea of the music of the heavens, thus the title of the piece, Moonlight Music, the suggestion that music offers space to bring harmony in the soul, and the embodiment of music by instrument and voice. As we sing this song, we hope that you will experience the music of the heavens through the instruments of our voices and hopefully allow you to find a bit of harmony in your own soul.
How sweet.
Henry Mancini with lyrics by Johnny Mercer. It won the Academy Award for Best Song in 1961 from the movie Breakfast at Tiffany's, featuring Audrey Hepburn and George Peppard. Of course, when we think of Moon River, Andy Williams' version often comes to mind. Steve Zegree, an internationally respected vocal jazz conductor and educator, arranged our version, and we hope you like it.
Composed by Michael Hennagin, features poetry by Walt Whitman. Written in 1865, the entire poem called Give Me the Splendid Silent Sun contrasts the poet's desire for nature as well as his comfort with New York City life during the Civil War. Although this musical piece only includes the first section of the poem, which is Walt Whitman's desire for nature, the pull between city life and nature can be heard within the dissonance throughout the piece. The song's dynamics also play a role in relating the tension between city, nature, and the war. Perhaps knowing the text to the entire poem answers the question as to why the composer ends the piece with an ominous chord, played by our accompanist, Kay Simpkin.
I'm going to speak with the microphone for a second here. I didn't put names in the program this time because my printer was running out of ink. But Laura and Kay are our accompanists, and they each had one piece that was just, they needed every key on the piano. Okay? And they've done a marvelous job, so thank them for being here.
Theme, we will be welcoming our son by picking up the pace of it. This next piece was written near the end of a particularly long, cold winter in England in 1969. You will note the lyrics that reflect this, as well as a longing for the return of warmer days. Alan Billingsley arranged this piece as a choral tribute to the original pop song. The tambourine and hand claps add an air of jubilance and excitement at the anticipation of spring and the return of sun. Please enjoy the Beatles' own George Harrison's Here Comes the Sun.
If you saw me go up and talk to the singers there for a second, it's because singing in here
is the exact opposite feeling of singing where we normally sing. I call this place the driest place to ever sing. They can't hear themselves very well up there because the ceiling is acoustic tile and it's right above their head. And so the sound just kind of goes up and stops. And so I have to keep reminding them to turn in. And this is kind of a backwards arch you have here. If it was this way, it might be a little easier for us, but it's kind of tough. And so I hope you could see him, and I hope you could hear him all. You have great microphones, that's the greatest thing in the world here. I tell him that's the good news and the bad news. I said, the microphones hear everything. That's the good news. Bad news is the microphones hear everything. So, but we'd really love coming here. Want to hope you all have a wonderful summer, enjoy the warm weather, get out and get some fresh air after this long winter we just talked about.
Another Day of Sun is the opening song for the film La La Land, released in 2016. This song, composed by Justin Hurwitz, serves as a type of opening overture, setting the stage for the movie. Justin won 2 Academy Awards for the music of La La Land and actually graduated from Nicolet High School in Glendale, Wisconsin. Imagine that you are stuck in a traffic jam while driving home from work on a beautiful Friday night. Only instead of angry, impatient people in the cars around you, people start to get out of their cars and sing and dance in a colorful, uplifting, and extravagant dance number. These young Hollywood hopefuls pursuing their dreams are a little uncertain about their future, yet optimistic. After the confusion wore off, you would feel less impatient about your wait and kind of inspired about your weekend. I hope that the evening that you have spent with us has left you similarly inspired to enjoy another day of sun.
Just insane.